In this session, we are going to discuss about the computer program VESTA as well as the fundamental properties of crystals, or we can say the crystalline parameters. VESTA is a powerful tool. Of course, it's a freeware. Is used to analyze or to simulate the powder XRD, X-ray diffraction patterns for solids. Similarly, by using the VESTA, it is possible to understand the basic crystalline parameters as well as the concepts behind the solid state. Right, before going into this, first let us download the VESTA, then from that we'll do the basic structural parameter analysis as well as the powder X-ray diffraction pattern analysis. Right, just type Google VESTA program. Now this is the site. So VESTA, visualization for electronic and structural analysis. This is the site, jpminerals.org. So from the bottom you can download it, you can go for the download, and from the bottom you can download, choose your operating system and then download. Now I am going to download for Windows 64-bit. So it's a zip file, so we have to unzip this and then we have to use it. So now the current version is 3.5.7. So just I'm downloading this one. Download started. So after unzipping, we can use the program. The program is downloaded. Now unzip this. Right, now open VESTA.exe, this file. So this is the main window. So now the thing is, here we are having different types of tabs are there, right? Now let us start with a simple example. First go to file, new structure, and then take the unit cell. Let us take, start with some simple. We are having seven types of crystal systems, you know: triclinic, monoclinic, orthorhombic, tetragonal, trigonal, hexagonal, cubic. Right, just for simplicity let us start with the cubic. Right, so cubic crystal means the lattice parameters A, which is equal to B, which is equal to C, and the angle, interfacial angle alpha, beta, gamma is 90 degree. Right now let us assume, for the sake of simplicity, let us assume the lattice value as 10 angstrom. Right, now cubic, I am taking the space group. Here we are having other space groups are disabled. So for the cubic crystal system, we are having different types of space groups, P23, F23. So different types of space groups are there. Now let us take, for example, let us take P23, this space group for cubic crystal system. Now put it OK. So now you are having the crystal. You are having a crystal having the lattice parameter A, which is equal to B, which is equal to C, that is 10 angstrom each. Now you can view through A and view through B, view through C. Now let us place some atoms here. Now this is just a basic unit cell. Now for simplicity, let us take an atom here. So just go to edit, edit data and unit cell, this one. So we have taken this already. So go to the structural parameters in this tab, take this tab. So now go to new, and in this say select new one. Say for example, let us take Fe, say label, let us Fe atom number 1. Now here the x, y, z is nothing but the coordinates, fractional coordinates. Say for example, let us take 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. What this means, the atom is located half from the origin along the A, along the x-axis, along the y-axis, along the z-axis. So the total is 10 angstrom along x, y, z. Now we are taking the value of the fractional coordinates 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. Now apply. Okay, that's it. Now the atom is placed here. So it is placed exactly from the A, from along the axis. Now suppose you are taking A, so along A it is about 0.5. along the x-axis it is 5 angstrom, along the y-axis it is 5 angstrom, and along the z-axis it is 5 angstrom, right? Now let us place one more atom. So go for edit data, unit cell and structure parameters, and here you click new. In this, say for example, now let us take, say for example, let us take oxygen. Let us assume oxygen atom as 1. Now instead of the fractional coordinates 0, let us put here I am putting as 1, here I am putting as 0, right? So from the origin x, 0. From the origin y, it is 1, that is full, that is 10 angstrom. Y is equal to 10 angstrom, x is equal to 0, whereas z is equal to 0. Now apply. So now, okay. So this is the thing. So now the thing is, this is the basic fun structure. So now we are having the oxygen atoms are placed in the corners, right? Now let us see, initially it seems to be confusing, but while we are moving towards in depth, then we can understand how to rearrange this position, how to mark these positions. Those things we will see in the next one. Okay, right now we have placed iron atom in the center, that is 5 angstrom along x-axis and 5 angstrom along y-axis and 5 angstrom along z-axis. Okay, and then similarly we have placed oxygen atom 0 angstrom from the origin along x-axis, whereas 10 angstrom along the y-axis and 0 angstrom along the z-axis. Right now, to understand this more clearly, now let us go for one more step. Let us move to one more step. Now let us see this. Here you are having boundary. Just click this boundary because we are having only one unit cell. Now we are going to expand the unit cell, right? So now click the boundary. Along the boundary, you can see x minimum, y minimum, z minimum. Similarly, x maximum, y maximum, z maximum. Means now we are having only one unit cell is present along x-axis, along y-axis, along z-axis. Now, let us take, put this as 2. So this means 2 unit cells. Now apply. So now you see along the, now apply and then just close this window. So if you are taking along X, or you can view along Y, that means B. A means view along the X axis, B means view along the Y axis, C means view along the Z axis. Now we have placed one more unit cell along the X axis. So now let us take the view along the B, that is along the Y axis. So now you see the structure is just expanded. One more boundary is there, right? Right now view along the Z axis, you can see. So the thing is, so this is the X axis, this is the X axis. So we expanded the cell along the X axis. So now again, this path continues infinitely. Now by the same way, we can introduce the atom in the Y. So how to do? Just click the boundary and then go to Y max 2, then apply. So now you can see it is expanded along both X axis, that is along the A, along the B. So here also, so you are having along the X axis, along the Y axis, whereas you are along the Z axis, there is only one unit cell is present along the Z axis, right? Right now, let us take the boundary again. Now, for example, let us put this as 3 instead of 2, so that we can understand. Now we are expanding two more unit cells along the Z axis. Apply. Okay. I think now you can understand. So here, you are having X axis. For example, in order to avoid the confusion, let us take this as 1, this as 1, X as 1, Y as 1, Z is equal to 3. Now apply, so that you can understand where the cell is get expanded. So this is first unit cell along the Z axis, C, along the C direction. So you are having one unit cell here, and this is the second unit cell, and this is the third unit cell. So you are having 3 unit cells. So since we just deleted the other two cells along the along the Y as well as X, so we are having the boundary as only in the boundary is only on the Z axis only. Okay, right. So by this way, we can understand the concept of how to expand the unit cell from the origin.